Thank you. place, but you kept me. It could have been a lot worse, but you kept opening doors. It could have been a lot worse, but you just keep on making a way. You just keep on making a way. Over and over and over again. Over and over and over again. Over and over and over and over again. All I ever do hurt. Oh, Lord, hurt me.
A couple were walking on a mountain road when they came across this preacher who was lying in the middle of the road with his ear to the ground. The preacher said, black Ford F-150, female driver, German Shepherd in the passenger seat, loaded down with firewood, with a Mississippi tag. And the couple was astounded and said to the preacher, you could tell all of that by just listening to the ground? And the preacher said, no, that's a description of the truck that just ran me over. You know, life is a lot like that. We do not always see what is coming, and when it does, it sometimes runs right over us. No matter how hard we try, we are bound to encounter things that are not good. But the good news in the message today is that although all things are not good, they work together for our good. Let's pray. Lord, right now we just thank you for being a good God, for being a good shepherd, for being the giver of all good and perfect gifts. And Lord, we just bless you for these things. And I just pray right now that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart would be accepted in your sight. And Lord, and in this Thanksgiving season that we'll be celebrating this coming Thursday, Thanksgiving Day, but we know for believers, every day is a day of Thanksgiving. And we just thank you. Because each day you give us new mercy. So we bless you right now. Just asking you to just have your way in this message on today. We ask this in Jesus' name. Don't let anything matter. Amen. I love BibleGate.com. Whenever I'm Googling scripture, I go to them. And if I'm able to look up a certain scripture, and I can get different translations of the scripture. And BibleGate.com, every year they do a list of their most searched Bible verses. And they publish it on their website. And this should come as no surprise to anyone that the most popular or the most searched verse is John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. And the second most searched Bible verse is Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you, to give you hope and a future. Rounding out the top three is Romans 8:28. We know all things work together for good, for those who love God and who are called according to his purpose. And it's Romans 8:28 that I based the message on today. It's been said that the words contained within Romans 8:28 are the crowning expression of Christian confidence. In the darkest of hours, when trials, tribulation, and troubles, when things that are not explainable, things that are not good happen, this verse brings comfort and gives direction and hope to Christians. when all around us is like shifting sand, this unshakable knowing gives us a foundation upon which to stand. For we know that all things work together for good for those who love God, who are called according to His purpose. This verse testifies to God's sovereignty, to His power, and to His rule over all power and all other rules. It lets us know that although there are things that are at work against us, God is at work in these things, and that all things work together for believers' good, though all things are not necessarily good for the believer. Now let's look at the text. Verse 28 begins with the words, "we know." Notice that it did not say that we think, or we feel, or perhaps, or maybe, or there's a chance, or a possibility that all things work together for our good, but with ironclad certainty, it says, "we know." Why do we know? We know, first of all, because God said so, and He's not a man that He should lie or change His mind. He's not one who speaks and then not act. He's not one who promises and not to feel. We know. And because God said, "I know the plan that I have for you," we in turn can say we know that all things work together for our good based on those plans that God has. It's interesting. When you look at the word for know in the Greek, it's not genoso, to know with knowledge, but it's the word eido that's translated as to perceive. To perceive an object that's looming within the mist. We can sense that it's true. In other words, we not only know God's words by facts and knowledge and information, but when we look around, we can discern it as being true. We know because of God's inerrant word. It tells us in 2 Corinthians 1:22 that God set His seal of ownership on us, and He put His Spirit in our hearts as a security deposit, as earnest money, as good faith guaranteed what is to come for us. God put His Holy Spirit within us to lead God and to direct us in all things. So that's why we can say we know. Psalms 139:16 says, "All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be." Letting us know that in this life, for those who love the Lord and are called, the fight is fixed. Therefore, we can say with confidence we know, because God is the maker of our days and He's the author of our story, a story that He wrote Himself into. We know that all things, although "all" is a small three-letter word, it encompasses everything that the world can possibly bring. The ups and the downs, the good and the bad, the happy and the sad, the just and the unjust, the healing and the hurtful, the sweet and the bitter, the explainable and the unexplainable. In all these things, we know that they work together for our good. The phrase "work together" in Greek is really one word, synergon. We get our English word synergy from this word. And what is synergy? It is what happens when you put two or more elements together to form something brand new that neither could form separately, whose interaction gives rise to a whole that's greater than the simple sum of its parts. For instance, sodium by itself is a deadly poison, as is chloride. But if you put sodium and chloride together, they become table salt. What was once harmful to ingest on its own now gives flavor to food. It balances fluid in our bloodstream. It's essential for nerve and muscle function. It becomes a preserver and is used on icy roads for traction. we know that all things work together for good. This does not mean, as is commonly thought, that everything would turn out okay in this life. And although all things might not work out for our everyday earthly good, all things work together for our eternal and our ultimate good. As a young boy, this scripture came to life for me as I watched my mother, Beatrice Johnson, prepare to bake her world-class almond chocolate cake. Since her cake was so good, I figured that the individual ingredients were good as well. And the first thing I tasted was the flour, but it was dry and bland on its own. And no one told me buttermilk was sour. I would not have tasted it had I known. And the baking powder and butter were no better. I could have left them on the table. Even the semi-sweet chocolate was bitter. And I was fooled by the smell of the vanilla flavor. And when she whipped them together with the mixer and placed the mix in the cake pan and placed it in the 400-degree oven for an hour. And after she took it out and she put the pecan coconut icing on top of it and allowed it a few minutes or a little while to cool and gave me a slice to taste and see that it was good, I understood how things that are not good can work together for good. These words that all things work together for good are so comforting until unbelievers, while quoting or hearing them, they receive a positive response from them. But the comforting response they're receiving is a false positive. It's an incorrect result. Because the verse does not say that all things work together for good and end. It says all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. But this promise of all things working together for good is not for everyone. It's a narrow promise. It's not for the good of all people, nor for people who are good, but rather for the good of those who love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. John 1:12 said, "Yet to all who did not receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God." And 2 John 1:6 identified those who love God as those who walk according to his commandments. We know that all things work together for good for those who love the Lord, who are the called. And when you look at the word called is defined as God's invitation to bring people to him through his Son, Jesus Christ. And the called are those who accept the invitation and they RSVP. They respond so very promptly. And the calling is a particular work God has called the call to do, to become unified with him in every aspect of life. And we respond to the call by walking in a manner worthy of our calling. And we know that all things work together for good for those who love God, who are the called according to his purpose. All things don't happen to work out on their own by some big bang theory that brings order out of disorder. Rather, God providentially works all things together for the good of his people, and he does it for a reason, according to his purpose. God has a perfect plan, and he has two purposes in that perfect plan: his glory and that his people will be edified. The reason that God gave us light to so shine and good works to show forth is so that he would be glorified and his people edified. What is good? For most of us, we can equate good with things like good health, happiness, a solid relationship, long life, money in the bank, gas in the tank, food on the table, a meaningful and well-paying job, a nice place to live. But in general, we think the good life means a better set of earthly circumstances. But our good and God's good are not always the same good. Verse 29 tells us that the good that all things were predestined to work together for is to transform us into the image of Christ, the image of the Son of the living God, who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. We know that all things work together for good for those who love God, who are called according to His purpose. But we don't see God's hand at work. He's there in all things for the good of those who love Him, though we cannot see it. As a pastor, I've often been asked, and when I visit the congregation and those who are going through, and I've often been asked, why did this have to happen to me or to man? When is it going to end? Where is God in all of this? And I have to say, I can't say why, and I can't tell them when, but I can tell them where God is. He's there working in all things for the good of those who love Him and are called according to His purpose. The Bible never asks us to pretend that tragedy isn't tragedy or to pretend that pain and suffering isn't real. But we have to know that in them God is working, moment by moment, arranging and rearranging all things for the believer's good. He's there, He's been there from the beginning, at the end, and everywhere in between, though we may not see His hand at work. It's been said that diamonds are a girl's best friend. But if you were to ask the diamond what it took for it to become a girl's best friend, it would say that it took being formed 93 miles beneath the earth's crust, within the earth's mantle, where it was subjected to temperatures between 2,000 and 2,200 degrees Fahrenheit, and had to experience 720,000 pounds per square inch of pressure. After it was formed, sometimes it was a volcanic explosion that brought it to the earth from the earth crust to the surface. And at other times, dynamite was used to separate it from the ore in the mantle. And once this ore was broken, it was loaded and transported to an ore crusher where the diamond was separated for processing. It was then taken to a master gem craftsman who used a diamond edge blade to cut it with. It was then buffed and rebuffed to bring out its full potential. It was then mounted on a ring to eventually be placed on the hands of one's beloved. Those who love the Lord and are called according to His purposes will sometimes find themselves in situations over their heads, in heated situations, under extreme pressure, sometimes blasted on every side, only to be brought to the surface to be cut by one of their own, to sometimes be buffed and rebuffed. You know, that's a lot to have to go through. When all of these things come in like a flood, Romans 8:31b tells us what we should say to those things. If God be for us, who could be against us? Although it's a rhetorical question, the answer to it is no one or no combination of things can be against us if God be for us. Romans 8:28 is teaching us this great truth. Although all things are not good, all things ultimately work together for the ultimate good of those who love and are called by God for His purpose. This is not a pat answer for every situation or question, but it does answer the big question. Does God know what He's doing? When confronted or confused by things that you don't understand, just ask yourself this question. Does God know what He's doing? Yes, He does. And because we know Him and we know that all things work together for good to those who love Him and those who are called by Him for His purpose, that should be enough to hold us to be able to get us through when we're going through all things. There are many things we don't know and perhaps we'll never know. We don't know why babies die before they're even born. We don't know why children experience extended illness and sickness. We don't know why COVID-19 hit church folk just as hard as it does unchurch folk. We don't know why, if it ain't one thing, it's another. We don't know why. But this one thing we do know. God is at work in all things. Therefore, when we are confronted by the unexplainable mysteries and circumstances of life, we need to erect a construction sign that reads, God at work. How is he going to work it out? Sometimes only God knows. When will he finish? When will this end? Only time will tell. What will be the outcome? For good and not for evil. Hang in there, we are one. Hang in there, my brothers and sisters in Christ. For we know that all things this old world can bring work together for our good. And so be it, and amen.
So